Well, it's been nearly 2 weeks since one of the biggest shocks in presidential election history.
Yeah, when Donald Trump became president-elect Donald Trump, we can maybe agree that a lot of us didn't see that one coming. But here in Minnesota, if you've lived here longer than 20 years, maybe you could have. The outsider was elected our governor here in 1998 to the shock of the press and to the entire country. And tonight, I want you to walk back there with me, with one of the architects of the Jesse Ventura campaign. And in this walk, you might see, we maybe could have seen Trump's win coming.
My name is Bill Hillsman. My company is Northwoods Advertising, and I was a chief strategist and media consultant for Jesse Ventura's campaign.
The Ventura campaign for governor was a campaign Bill describes as barely even bare bones, but it was one that lit a fire in Minnesota voters. No one could see, not even the press, because it happened through the original social media. It happened on the internet. Message board.
His field force basically organized themselves. We would go into towns, we would keep people posted on the internet, and we would go into towns, but we weren't sure if there would be a crowd or not, and there always was. So that's when we knew something was afoot.
Sounds familiar.
Yeah.
A grassroots online support system growing like weeds in the woods? Well, even that wasn't enough to convince the Ventura staff in 1998, or the body himself.
Be honest, in 1998, did you think you had a snowball's chance in hell?
No, I thought we had a snowball's chance, but I don't really, no, I thought he would top out at best at 30% of the vote.
So you win. Were you shocked?
Yes, I wasn't as shocked as Jesse Ventura was, but I was shocked. Nobody quite knew what to do. Because nobody had prepared for this. So I found myself at 3:30 in the morning, sitting in a Denny's, writing out step by step on a legal sheet what I thought they needed to do.
All right, come on, guys. Doesn't some of this sound eerily familiar to what just happened? Swarms of people at rallies each time they went on, a social media presence and campaign that spread like wildfire, and a staff with a candidate that really didn't think the win was a sure thing. All right, if that's not enough, remember this part of 1998.
Why did Minnesota choose Ventura?
Well, it sounds quaint now, but people were really fed up with the government here. They wanted change in a big way. They wanted to send a message to government, and that's what they did.
Doesn't that sound familiar?
It certainly does.
Minnesotans, you have seen this before. You elected the outsider, because many of you believe that outsider would completely steamroll the way state government was and make it into something else. You proved back then the voter was boss.
Yes, it did prove that citizens still can, they can hire whoever they want. And when they're pushed to certain levels, they will hire whoever they want.
Sounds familiar.
Seems like that's what a lot of Americans did this time around. Proved the voters are always boss when it comes to elections.
Now, was the Ventura governorship what people wanted once that happened? Well, that's for you to debate over your hot dish this Thanksgiving, not for us to conclude.
It was so very interesting, though. And it's just, you wonder why someone would run if they had no earthly idea that they could win or what would come next.
With Jesse, it started on his radio show. He just said, maybe I should run for governor. And people started going bananas. And he's like, maybe I should run for governor. Maybe I should run for governor. And he did. So
there
who knows?
You have it. And we survived.
Yeah, we did. I don't remember. I lived in Missouri, but y'all did.
We'll be right back.